Hi, I'm Neil Schiavelli. I'm a celebrity makeup artist, and today I'm going to walk you through the fundamentals of anti-aging makeup. I'm going to show you what not to do and what to do to create a more youthful looking face. The key to a youthful face is really focusing on structuring the brows so that they really help to frame your face. Your brows can instantly give structure and also lift the look of your face. What you don't want to do is use too dark of a color or overfill your brows. That can start to make things look a little bit too unrealistic. I like to use this product by Ico called Brow Boost, and it actually contains brow fibers in it, so it's going to cling to your brows all day, creating a more volumized, full look to your brows. This will help create that really nice, natural look. To help create that big, bold look for your eyes, instead of using your eyeliner on the inner waterline of the eye, just use your eyeliner on the lash line. So on your lower lashes, you just want to follow your lower lash line and create a simple, pretty thin line. This will help keep your eyes looking open, bright, and more youthful, whereas using the liner in your waterline can start to close the eye shape, making them look smaller. When considering an anti-aging makeup routine, I would suggest staying away from powder foundations. They can tend to give more of a dry look. They can also settle into fine lines and wrinkles. So steer away from powders and head over to using more cream formulas. I love using cream formulas on my clients because they give a really nice dewy finish to the skin. I love using the Luminous Silk Foundation by Armani. It's my go-to for creating a youthful glow. I've seen a lot of women use dark matte colors on their lips, and they tend to bring out the dryness in your lips. These dark matte colors can start to look a little bit harsh and also age you. So the goal is to brighten and lighten up the face, and I do that with a cream sheer formula. So you can opt for berries, you can do a sheer pink. I would just steer away from any harsh matte colors. If you use a sheer creamy formula with hydrating properties in it, like shea butter or any types of essential oils in it, they're gonna really help to plump the lips up. Today I'm using this color by Jouer Cosmetics called Meredith, and it's my go-to for creating more of a sheer, creamy look. It'll also help diminish the look of fine lines and wrinkles. We all love to use some highlighter, right? It helps to brighten the face, it also helps to reflect light, but I would steer away from using a powder highlighter just because it can settle into fine lines and wrinkles around the eyes. I like to use a creamy formula, which also helps to reflect light, but it won't settle in fine lines and wrinkles. And you would apply it in the same areas, just above the cheekbone. This will really help bring light to the face and just create that overall youthful glow. I've seen so many people put blush in the wrong place, and it can really drag your facial features down and give a very hollow look. You don't want to apply blush in the hollows of your cheeks. You actually want to apply it on the apples of the cheek, which is going to give a more youthful, uplifted look. A way to easily find where you can put your blush is if you look in the mirror and smile. You really want to just place the blush on the apples of the cheeks. I hope these tips helped, and I hope you try them all at home. I'm Neil Schiavelli, and thank you so much for watching New Beauty.